We traveled Kansas and Missouri spreading the good news. Preacher's family with our pressed clothes and worn out polished shoes. Mama fixed us soup beans and served them up by candlelight. She tucked us in and I know she worried through many a sleepless night. Dad and me, we went to the store when the work was done. Standing at the counter, he said, I forgot to get the peaches, son. What kind should I get? I said to him there where he stood in line. And he answered, just as I knew he would, go and get the cheapest kind. Among the people all dressed so fine. He usually has a paper sack and it's clutched real tight. His work clothes are dirty, he don't look nobody in the eye. Oh, he was little and he was wiry and he was not too fun. And he was rocky as the roadside dirt back where he came from. And they were raising seven children on that little farm and not the best of times. And the few things they got from the store were always the cheapest kind.
But love, it was not the cheapest kind. It was riches, riches, riches.
People, I just don't understand. I always wish I could be holding on to my grandpa's hand so he could lead me off down that long road somewhere. Back to that little farmhouse where there's just enough supper for whoever's there. Oh, my people's hands and faces, they are so dear to me. All I have to do is close my eyes and they're so near me. I have to laugh, I have to cry when I think of the things that have drawn those lines. So many years making do with just the cheapest kind.
Fred Newman. We brought Fred up from poverty, up from disgrace. We brought him up from life in Georgia, in the piney woods of Georgia, where he lived with just his coon dog out there.
Get your finger out the dog's ears, Fred.
Lived with his dog out there in the woods, just grits and cheese. Grits and government cheese. That's all he was living on out there. Yep. Just hunting down possum, hunting them, selling them for pets. You was a troublemaker down there in Georgia. They couldn't get rid of Fred quick enough. He would sit in school behind kids who were taking tests, SAT tests that would determine their entire future as adults. He would sit right behind them and he would make dripping sounds. He would make intestinal sounds. Those kids did not get into Yale or Princeton. No, they did not. They went to small technical schools. They became dog barbers. Yep. Come on, Mike. Come on. No, Fred was trouble. Fred knew how to make different alarms, all kinds of alarms. And he liked to do them on the public address system at the high school. Every day, a new alarm. School was evacuated. Over and over again. And then one day there was an alarm, and people said, well, that's just Fred, that's all. That was the day the school blew up. The boiler blew up. Children were blown high in the air. Fortunately, this was the week that LaGrange, Georgia was seeking to get into the Guinness Book of World Records with the largest serving of grits in America. It was a bowl of grits. As big as this amphitheater. It was about 5 acres of grits. And it had cheese in it. Heavy with cheese. And those kids landed, or they were blown into the air, and they landed in the grits. And they never ate grits ever again in their lives. Right? No, and not you either. But they put him on a train, headed up north. Up there with an old hobo named Brett.
Yeah, how you doing?
Me. Was that a train crossing? That was, wasn't it? I thought for a moment that was a marimba. No, it was a train crossing. Oh, that's good. Boy, you could almost make a living doing the sound effect. He got up to Minnesota and he got a job at the state fair, and he was that carousel needs repair. Well, that's got a few flat notes in it, doesn't it? No, he was a knife thrower. He had a knife throwing act there in the Midway with a comely woman named Renee.
Hello, Renee.
And she would stand in her bikini. This was a healthy size bikini, not the kind they wear nowadays. This was back in the day, like a foundation garment, a foundation bikini. A trainer bikini. And she stood against a sheet of 3/4-inch plywood, and he threw knives at her. Just missed. People stood and watched. They paid admission for this. They watched with apprehension and hope. And then, let's do this in slow motion now, so they see this closely. He threw one a little too close, and it hit the strap of her top. And it... Hollywood producer who was there, just as there is here today, I'm sure. And of course there was. And he saw what Fred could do. And he signed him.
Take it to Hollywood. Hollywood.
Put him on the Sunset Limited, headed out for Hollywood. Oh, that was better, actually. That was better. You're kidding me. Got out to Hollywood, and he did westerns. He did horses. Cows. He did beef cattle. He did cow. See that again. So doing gangster movies and cars going around sharp corners.
What are you taking me for? Why is
that? All of that. And then he was so good at that firearms stuff that he was hired to do the whole Normandy invasion. Ships, planes, artillery. Fast forward to the end. There you go. Okay. And then he was hired to do the entire sinking of the Titanic.
Eight bells and all is well. Women and children to the lifeboats! Women and children to the...
He made one mistake, but as the great ship went down, humpback whales swam around it, and they were singing. It was meant to be a dirge. But they found out that if you ran the soundtrack backwards, what those whales were singing was, "Roll me over in the clover." So, it was fired. That's why we took him in. We took him in and we tried to make a man out of him. Yep, he does sound effects for our sponsors on our show. We have a champagne sponsor.
Champagne.
We had an appliance company, Fritz Appliances, and they made juicers that would juice 6 bushels of apples in just 10 seconds. You could put in a whole side of beef for protein.
That's good hoof.
You put in a whole slab of plywood for fiber. Now they made all sorts of things. They made espresso machines that would do light roast like that. And they would do dark roast. They would do French roast. We had another sponsor, and we had a sponsor for a while, the National Rifle Association. The old West
the old time, the old wind singing through the red, red grass, a thousand miles, and Spanish Johnny you. He'd sit beside a water ditch when all his heart was in, and never mind a child but sing to his mandolin, to his mandolin. The big stars, the blue night, the moon enchanted lane, the olive men who never spoke but sang the songs of Spain. His talk with men was wicked talk, to hear it was a sin. But those were golden things he said to his mandolin, to his mandolin.
Many times our burdens been heavy.
is the love that we share and the way that we care when we're long, long gone. We struggle to bring up our children and teach them how and what for. Eyes like the morning star, cheeks like a rose. Laura was a pretty girl, God Almighty knows. We bore you little rains, whale winds, wail. All alone, 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 the Colorado Trail. Surely they learned this song. Surely. I ride an old paint, I lean an old paint. I'm gone, Montana, to throw away. They feed them in the coolies, they water them in the dark. Their tails are all matted, their backs are
at the age of 12 years old.
growing up in Wimberley, Texas, the first song she ever sang in public. It's just us two. I wanna be somebody's cowboy, and I hope it can be you.
Find my way through the wild. Don't mind whether it's a window blow.
Passengers will please refrain from flushing toilets while the train is standing in the station. I love you. While the train is in the station, you must practice constipation. If the train can't do it, then why should you? Be kind to your well-footed friends. Somebody's mind. Be kind to your friends in the spot where the weather is very cold and bad. You may think that this is the end, but it's not, because there's one more moment. Be kind to your friends in the spot where the weather is very cold and bad. Good night, ladies. Tour sponsor Ford, Go Further, for helping us out tonight, and thank all of the public radio stations in Colorado and all of our listeners. Thank you so much for coming out. This is wonderful amateur Richard Crean over here on the Randy Man. Mr. Chris Siebel, Mr. Mary Collett back here on the bass. Mr. Bernie Gressel playing the drum. Chris Joyce over here at the piano. Sarah Giroux, Mr. Fred Miller, thanks to our crew double back on the back of the Sam Hudson, who's been showing up so as to leave the sound on stage, and Stephen Evans did all these lights. Tony Oxtell did the house sound up there, Olivia Pelham, our researcher, and Melanie Jones Schmitz, our stage hand. This is the last song that they do at the Such a Canoe Banquet in Lake Bobegon, get together in the fall, and all these old sentimental men, and they sing all the Norwegian songs they know, Kanda Glemagamla Norway, and Bondum's Yamet, all of them. And then they sing this last song. These old men my age wondering if this is the last meatloaf supper they'll ever have. If this is the last rhubarb pie, if this is the last weak cup of coffee with the oil slick on top, I sing this old hymn. Fading away like the stars in the morning, losing their light in the glorious sun. Thus would we pass from this earth and its toiling, only remembered for what we have done.
Only remembered, only remembered, only remembered for what we have done.
Thus would we pass from this earth and its toiling,
only remembered for what we have done.
Only the truth that in life we have spoken, only the seed that in life we have sown, these shall pass onwards when we are forgotten, only remembered for what we have done, everybody.
Only remembered. Only remember, only remember for what we have done.
These shall pass onwards when we are forgotten.
Only remember for what we have done.
Who'll sing the anthem and who'll tell the story? Will the line hold? Will it shatter and run? Shall we at last be united in glory, only remembered for what we have done?
Only remembered, only remembered for what we have done.
Shall we at last be united in glory,
only remembered for what we have done? Only remembered for what we have done.
Thank you, everybody.
And here's to the quiet and the bold, and old and young and large and small. So fill to me the parting glass. Good night and joy be with you. All here's to our friends, our true, true friends. Some walk the earth and some have flown away. The truest treasure that we know, we say a prayer for them today. And to you, friends, whom I just met, as now the evening shadows fall, oh, fill to me the parting glass. Good night